Namaste everyone from Joy of Reading. Today's story is Anna's Extraordinary Experiments with Weather. The author is Nandita Jayaraj, illustrator Priya Kurian, and published by Pratham Books. Anna, okay, I think it refers to the name of some person and seems to be it's the name of this lady here, I think, for the most part. And extraordinary, meaning something remarkable, out of the world. Anna's extraordinary, remarkable experiments. Experiment is what we do to test something out, right? And what does she want to test or experiment with? With the weather. Weather is nothing but the state of air or atmosphere. What is it at that particular place or at that time? Like, is it cloudy, dry, hot, cold? What is it, right? So Anna seems to be this lady who has done some remarkable experiments with weather to try out how to maybe measure the weather at a certain place, whether it is too hot, cold. We will see what it is. Phew, phew. Anna Mani blew out all 8 candles on her birthday cake. Happy birthday, Anna, shouted her brothers and sisters. Anna had a big family and a big house on her hill. But on her birthday, she had only one small wish. So Anna is this little girl here, and it is her 8th birthday. So, and everyone in her house, brothers, sisters, you can see parents, grandparents, wishing her a happy birthday as she's blowing out the candles. But she had only one small wish. Anna tore open her birthday gift and peered in. There was something sparkling inside. Diamond earrings? She did not want diamond earrings. They were expensive and useless. Do you know what Anna really wished for? Books, books, and more books. So Anna tore open her, she just tore it open like this, her birthday gift, and she saw inside like this, peered in. And what was there? Something shiny, sparkling, and it was diamond earrings. And what did she say? She didn't want diamond earrings because they are costly but useless. And what did she really wish for? She wanted a lot of books. We have books at home, said her brother. But Anna had already read those. There are more in the library, pointed out her grandfather. But Anna had read those too. She marched into her room. So she has read all the books at her home, all the books in the library, and she had no books now to read. So she marched like this, angrily, like that. Later that day, there was a knock on Anna's door, but there was nobody outside. Instead, there lay a big box at her doorstep. This better not be more jewelry, she said loudly. It wasn't. It was a brand new encyclopedia set. So many books, hooray! Anna ran around her house, hugging everyone. So one day there was a knock, tick, 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 when we tap on someone's door, right? Like tick, tick, tick. And when she opened it, she saw there was no one, but a huge box was there. And what was in it? Books. They were encyclopedia. What are encyclopedias? They are these reference books that contain a lot of information on a particular subject. So there are many encyclopedias covering various number of subjects. So she got a whole bunch of them. And she was so happy that she shouted, hurrah! And then she ran around the house hugging everyone. Many years and many, many, many books later, Anna found a job in the laboratory of a famous scientist. "What should I do here?" asked Anna. The scientist pointed to a box. "What do you think she found inside?" So Anna soon found a job in a lab, and she was in the path of doing research in science. So she found a job in the lab of the famous Nobel laureate, or a person who has received the Nobel Prize in Physics, Dr. Sir C.V. Raman. So she had a chance to work in his lab. And then she asked her fellow scientists what she should do there. And then they showed a box. Let us see what is there inside the box. "Diamonds, yeah," said Anna. But this time the diamonds were not to be worn. They were for experiments. The scientist wanted Anna to find out what makes diamonds shine. So she read books about diamonds, books, books, and more books. So Anna was like, again diamonds? But then what was she asked to do? To find out why diamonds shine. And she had to research about it. So read more and more books. Being a scientist was the best. Anna could study anything she wanted. So being a scientist, she had this opportunity to read about a lot of things, because she has to know about a lot of things, and books are the ones that help you know. Anna did hundreds of experiments. She built many gadgets to measure the weather of a place. So Anna did a lot of experiments. Experiment is when you conduct something, you do something to test out. So she built a lot of gadgets. Gadgets are tools. It could be electronic gadgets, mechanical gadgets. So what gadgets? Why did she want to build these gadgets? To measure the weather in a place. "How sunny is it in Bombay?" Anna built a gadget to measure that. "How windy is it in Madras?" Anna built a gadget for that too. So Anna built all these tools or gadgets to measure how much sun or how hot it is in Bombay, and how much the wind is blowing, how much is the wind, how to measure the wind. She built a gadget for that too. Look at her lab here. Her favorite gadget took many months to build. It was a special balloon called ozone sonde. It had a small machine fixed to it. The machine measured a gas found in the air called ozone. Ozone sondes fly really high. Look, there goes Anna's ozone sonde. So this must be the ozone sonde. She took a long time to build this. What is it? It is a special balloon which has a gadget attached to it. And what did it measure? Something called ozone in the air. So the air is made of several gases. Ozone is a pale blue gas that is there. About some 24 kilometers above the surface of the earth is the ozone layer. And what is it helpful for? It absorbs all the harmful radiations that are coming from the sun. So that is what ozone helps us with. And she found a gadget or a tool that could measure the amount of ozone. Look at this ozone sonde here. It just goes, flies up, up, up into the air. Guess how many gadgets Anna Mani built in all? Nearly 100 weather gadgets. She even had her own factory to make these gadgets. It was as if she could build anything. So Anna Mani built about some 100 weather gadgets. Today we talk about solar energy, which requires us to understand about solar radiation and everything. Anna Mani was the one who helped in building one of those gadgets, measuring wind so that we can utilize wind energy to convert it into electrical or anything else, right? So Anna Mani's gadget was used to measure the wind that is blowing. So she had so many of these gadgets, and currently all these environmentally friendly energy solutions we are looking for, Anna Mani had built so many gadgets to help measure out these things. Look at her lab. Isn't it wonderful with so many of these gadgets or tools out here? Anna Mani became one of the wisest weather scientists in India. Even as she grew older and more well-known, her best friends remained the same. Books, books, and more books. So Anna Mani was one of our famous weather scientists, the person who's involved in the study and measuring of weather, the climate around us, be it hot, cold, dry, cloudy, anything, right? So she had built so many gadgets and is one of the most popular scientists. Life and times of Anna, a timeline. 23rd August 1918, Anna Mani is born in Peer Medu in Kerala. 1940, she gets a scholarship to work at C.V. Raman's laboratory in Bangalore. 1945, she leaves for England to study meteorology. 1948, she returns and joins the Indian Meteorological Department in Pune. So she was born in 1918 in Peer Medu in Kerala. And in 1940, she joins the lab of Dr. C.V. Raman, Sir C.V. Raman in Bangalore. And that's where she did some of her experiments there. And after that, in 1945, she goes to England to study meteorology. What is meteorology? It is the science that helps us to measure weather on a day-to-day basis. So that is meteorology. And those who study meteorology are called meteorologists. And then she joins, when she comes back from England after her study, she joins the Indian Meteorological Department in Pune to further continue to work in the field she has studied. 1962, she starts work on the Ozone Sond project. 1976, she retires as Deputy Director General of the Indian Meteorological Department. In the 1980s, exact year unknown, she starts her own company to manufacture her gadgets. 16th August 2001, Anna Mani passes away in Kerala. So in 1962 is when she worked on this Ozone Sond project. And then she retired. She was a deputy director general in the meteorological department in India. So she retired, meaning she said, hey, you know what? She's done with the work there. And somewhere in the 1980s, she started her own company to manufacture tools to measure weather, right? All these gadgets to measure weather. And in 2001, in August, she passed away. She left us. Wonderful weather words. Meteorologist. Say it like this. Meet your all o gist. Meteorologist. A meteorologist is a scientist who studies the weather and climate of a region. Anna Mani was one of the best meteorologists there ever was. Ozone Sond. Say it like this. Ozone Sond. Ozone Sonds are balloons that fly high up into the sky. The balloons have gadgets fixed to them that measure the amount of ozone present in the air. Ozone is important because it blocks out harmful light coming from the sun. Too little ozone high up in the sky means we are in trouble. If you could be a scientist, what would you want to study? So, meteorologist. How do we say this? Meteorologist. So, a meteorologist is a person who's a scientist who studies weather and climate of a region. So, Anna Mani was the top in her field. She was one of the best meteorologists. And what is ozone sond? You have to say it like O, zone, sond. They are these balloons that fly up high up in the sky. And they have these, you can see in the picture, a small gadget fixed to them so that it measures the amount of ozone. As I said before, ozone is one of the gases present in the atmosphere or air. And what does it help with? It helps block out all the harmful light or radiations coming from the sun. And very little ozone means that we are in trouble because those harmful radiations would reach us. So, and that's what you can find out more in the web as well about ozone layer depletion or reduction. So I hope you enjoyed reading the story with me and being inspired by Anna Mani, who in that day and age strove hard and became one of the famous scientists out here. Thank you. Let us see some of the difficult words in the story. Peer, look with concentration at something or someone. Extraordinary, remarkable. Atmosphere is the layer of gas that surrounds Earth, is also called air. Gadgets, tools, they could be electrical or mechanical. Meteorology, study of weather or climate of a region. Try out some of these questions. What can humans do to protect the ozone layer? If you can build a gadget, what gadget do you want to build and to measure what? Name some other Indian women scientists. Thank you.